We're in conversation with Sanjay Suri, who's written a book 30 years down the line on the 1984 anti-Sikh riots. Sanjay, thanks very much for speaking to us on The Quint.
Great to be talking to you.
We understand you were personally affected as well. You were a target, you were saying?
Yes, I had gone reporting to Sultanpuri and hundreds were killed just down a couple of streets in Sultanpuri. And I was driving and I was stopped down this lane by a group of people who I later discovered to be Congress party workers. And they said, all is well here, go back. But then I saw a man beckon to me from a distance and I drove past, went there. He was a Sikh who had cut his hair. He said, these people have killed people all around us, they'll kill some more. So when I came back, turned around and drove back, these people has blocked the way. And suddenly somebody opened the front door, my driver's door. He punched me, he snatched my notes. Then Shevanti Nayan, my colleague, was in the back seat along with, and there were two other colleagues with us. And they grabbed her and they grabbed her notes. And that's when I decided to make a run for it. And I put the car into gear and just drove. I think I hit one of these as I went past, but I wasn't going to care about that. There was just no sense of the police anywhere.
And of course, speaking to victims and having read a few reports, one gets the sense that it's not so much the failure of the state, but the state actively being involved in this.
You see, the failure of the state is also criminal. If you and I see an act of violence and we turn away, then we can be indifferent. If the police see violence and they turn away, that negligence is criminal and it is actionable under law. And I try to bring that perspective into this book, that this was not moral negligence, it was criminal negligence that demands to be acted upon.
Right. Just to quote a line from your book, you say that the debate over 1984 has continued far too long without a close enough reference to the law. Was that what you were just referring
exactly, to? Exactly. Because, you know, what we have by way of a debate is a ding-dong trade of allegations in one occasion, one anniversary after another. There are a lot of police officers and policemen who can be prosecuted and jailed over their failures in 84. And this book seeks to bring that perspective into this debate.
And speaking of police officers, you also say that your book was in a way possible 30 years down the line, partly because these police officers, or some of them, are now able to speak freely.
You see, we all know that Ved Marwa inquired into these riots, and his inquiry, his report was aborted at the very last minute. And it could only have been aborted by the government of the day, Congressi government, led by the Prime Minister. Certainly as a serving officer, Ved Marwa could not speak then, but now I could have a lengthy interview where he has spoken at length about what he found.
What are your personal hopes, Sanjay, for what this book can achieve?
My personal hope is no more than this, that debate should not be just a repeat allegation exercise, that I place on the table my experiences and facts and records that I hope will inform the debate, that I hope will be a presentation of facts and experiences that somebody could take note on for purposes of action under law. It is not enough to call this a moral failure. It is a criminal failure under law that demands action and prosecution. This book makes a case for justice.
And on that note, do you believe that justice will be achieved in this case?
It's a very slender hope, very slender, but that hope does persist.